Do you want to be a better student? Maybe you're just starting university and you want to give it your best shot. Or you've been a student for a number of years and you know there's always room for improvement. Well, this is what these series are for. Hashtag study hacks, where we take psychological science and apply it on how to be an optimal student. My name is Saeed Chavoshi, and I'm a doctoral student here in clinical psychology at York University. And I want to show you how you can take lessons from psychological science to help you be the best student you can be during your time at York University. Now, as a student, you may be so busy that you'll try to do many things at once. Writing essays, talking to your friends, being on your phone. And this is what today's session is about, multitasking. Or more importantly, the myth of multitasking. So what is multitasking? Well, for some of you, it's taking notes while you're talking to your friends, trying to read your book while watching Netflix. But most of us these days, the way we multitask is with our phones. We check our phones up to 150 times a day, a recent study showed. And oftentimes when we check it, we're looking at our notification, text messages, and that could take up to a minute or 2 minutes. Now, what is the harm in doing this type of multitasking? First of all, there is no such thing as multitasking. What we do when we multitask is called task switching. It's when you take your attention away from one activity and put it towards another activity. So imagine you're working on an essay for, let's say, for your first year psychology course. You have to remember the important topics that you're talking about, the people, the grading scheme, how long the essay should be, your thesis. And as you shift your attention away to, you've just checked your phone and you're about to text your friend about going to the movies this weekend. You have to remember the movies, the time, do you like this friend, why are you going out? And every time we shift attention from one activity to another, we get rid of all this relevant information we've built up. It's like a sandcastle that crumbles every time we switch from one activity to another. And this is not only time consuming, it takes a lot of energy. So if you've ever tried to study while talking to a friend, after 10 minutes, you are feeling tired. Multitasking, or in other words, task switching, is energy consumptive. It's very tiring. Now, what's the real harm in task switching? It has a real hit on your productivity. When you task switch, research shows it takes you 40% longer to do the same set of activities if you were to do them separately without interruptions. That means it takes you twice as long to do something when you're multitasking. Also, you make a lot of mistakes. Minor errors to major errors are abundant when students try to write an essay or to study or to take notes when they're doing a number of activities at once. So what have we covered so far? First, there is no such a thing as multitasking. What we do is task switching, taking our attention from one task and redeploying our attentional resources to another task. This is tiring, time consuming, and we make more errors. And most of us, we multitask using our phones, usually interruptions that take a minute or two. And these can really impede your ability to learn. As a matter of fact, there's been a ton of research on this lately, looking at students showing how when they have their laptops in the classroom, they can't study as well because they constantly are distracted by going on Facebook or checking the news or doing something that's unrelated to the lecture. Similarly, when students are told to turn off their cell phones in the lecture, studies showed that the grades significantly improved. What can we do with this knowledge that this hurts your studying habits? Let's begin by understanding why it's so hard to stop multitasking. Why do we do it in the first place? Because the things we multitask with, whether Snapchat, Facebook, Instagram, these are appealing to our brains. They're rewarding. It's like a candy. It's like a warm hug. Your brain releases the same chemicals, dopamine for example, that you do when you're anticipating pleasure and reward. Things that are rewarding can become very addictive. It's very hard for us to not check our phones when the notification signal is flashing. It's almost like it's taunting us. Check me, check me. And most of us cannot resist because every time we check our phone, our brain releases chemicals that makes us feel good, that makes us feel interested. Now, what if you are not multitasking. If you're sitting somewhere where the person in front of you has a laptop open and they're multitasking, maybe watching a hockey game, checking the news while the lecture is going on, a recent study showed that that impacts you negatively too. So not only does multitasking affect your ability to learn, it also impedes and hurts those around you. In other words, it's bad for you, it's bad for your neighbor, and it's hard to stop because the things we multitask with are super addictive. So what can we do about that? Well, I'll tell you in a moment. So you know now multitasking is bad for you, but maybe you're thinking, no, I'm good at it. I've been doing it for so long. I know how to multitask. It makes me more efficient. Well, you're not alone in thinking that. Multitasking makes us feel like we're doing more work because you feel busy. You're pushing your brain to its limits. It's like going to the gym and working out really sore. You feel like you've done a really good workout. But in fact, when you objectively look at the results, when you multitask, even though you feel like you're doing more work, you actually end up doing a lot less. But the real damage is not just in the hit in productivity and your ability to learn. It's in fact a reduction in your ability to pay attention. That's right. Multitasking can damage your brain and your ability to focus. There was a recent study showing that students who multitask a lot have a reduced ability to pay attention, and get this, a reduced ability to multitask compared to students who don't do it. In other words, this is not a skill you develop. This is a habit that makes you worse at everything you do. If by now you have come to the conclusion that multitasking is bad for you, it harms your ability to study, to listen in lecture, to learn material, and to write properly, what can you do about it? Well, the solution is chunking. It's a very simple solution, is to divide your studying time into discrete amounts of time during which you don't let yourself to multitask. For example, if you're sitting down to study, you tell yourself, I'm gonna study for half an hour, during which I can only do one activity, and after that, I can take a break. As a matter of fact, there's a technique called the Pomodoro technique, which works like this. There's a timer and you study for 25 minutes. After 25 minutes, you have a 5-minute break, during which you can go walk around, check your phone, and you come back and you do another 25. You repeat this 4 times and then you get a 15-minute break. Simple, right? But this system is amazing in helping students do better in school. Now, there's a catch though. In the Pomodoro technique, during one Pomodoro, you can only do one activity. And you cannot check your phone or check your email until break time. During that break time, do whatever you need to do. After break is over, make sure to turn your phone over, or better yet, put it in your bag so you don't have to look at it. In the next module, in the Study Hack series, we're gonna talk about different ways where you can modify your digital environment, including your laptop, such that you're not as distracted. But remember, the main takeaways of this module are this. Multitasking doesn't work, it doesn't exist. What we do is task switching, taking our attention from one activity to another. This is harmful, it takes a lot of energy, and we end up being much less productive. But worst of all, we end up not learning and retaining information when we do this. So every time you take your phone out in lecture, not only do you miss the 30 seconds you're checking your notifications, you also miss the last few minutes because they were not processed anymore. They get wiped out of your mind. It's the real harm of the occasional glance to your cell phone. What can you do? Put the phone away, or better yet, learn to study in discrete amounts of time. One useful technique is the Pomodoro technique, which we discussed, and you can find links to it below. There are many free apps that can do it for you on your computer or on your cell phone, so you can have a timer wherever you go. And best of all, when you use an app like the Pomodoro app on your phone, you can track your productivity and graph it. You can see how many Pomodoros you're doing in a week, how much time you're studying, and that can really help you see where you stand relative to your courses. Because one of the tools that can help us study better is keeping track of how much we study, something we call feedback, which we will discuss in a future module. Thank you for listening, and check out the resources below. And don't forget, chunk your study time and use the Pomodoro technique.